Now for the pirate's lair. Oh, joy unbounded. Oh, sweet relief. Oh, rapture unexampled. At last I may atone in some slight measure for the repeated acts of theft and pillage, of which, at a sense of duty, stern dictation,
birthday. And knowing my birthdays, you're only my reporter. You don't mean to say you're actually going to hold me to that.
No.
We merely remind you of the fact and leave the rest to your sense of duty.
Your sense of duty?
Oh, don't put it on that footing. As I was merciful to you just now, be merciful to me. I implore you not to insist upon the letter of your bond, just as the cup of happiness is at my lips.
We insist on nothing. We content ourselves with pointing out to you your duty.
Your duty. Well, you have appealed to my sense of duty. And my duty is only too clear. I abhor your infamous calling. I shudder at the thought to think that I was ever mixed up in it. But duty is before all. At any price, I will do my duty.
Plainly spoken! Come, Frederick, you are one of us once more. Lead on, I follow.
Oh, horror!
What is the matter? Ought I to tell you?
No, I cannot do it.
And yet...
Speak up, my boy! I charge you by that sense of conscience!
Conscientiousness!
Conscientiousness! I charge you by that sense of conscientiousness, to which, however, we've never yet appealed in vain.
General Stanley, the father of my beloved Mabel.
Yes, yes.
He escaped from you on the plea that he was an orphan.
Yes,
he
did.
Oh, it breaks my heart to betray the honored father of the girl that I adore. But as your apprentice, I have no alternative. None. It is my duty to tell you that General Stanley is no orphan.
What?
More than that, he never was one.
Am I to understand that to save his contemptible life, he dared to practice on our treacherous simplicity? Our revenge shall be swift and terrible. We will go and collect our band of pirates and attack this castle this very night.
No.
Stop the word here! No!
Oh,
is clear. We must go to best to tackle these pirates
alone.
It is most distressing to be the agents whereby our erring fellow creatures are deprived of that liberty which is so dear to us all. But we should have thought about that before we joined the force.
We should!
Oh, it's too late now. When a fellow's not engaged in his employment, or maturing his felonious
little plans,
his capacity for innocent enjoyment, is just as great as any honest man. Our feelings feel with difficulty smother. Any duties to be done. I'll take one consideration with another.
Although
these things lost us not unhappy one.
Oh,
and if any duties to be done.
Station. We charge you yield. We I